Hi, welcome to Thorlabs. My name is Dave, and today I'm going to be talking about measuring the insertion loss of optical fiber components. Today we're going to show you what's called a single-ended or one-cable reference insertion loss test. I think this is the most straightforward procedure for an insertion loss test and hopefully most useful in a lab setting. In this test, the idea is that we're going to look at the optical power output from a reference cable and then compare that to the optical power output from a component connected to this reference cable. By comparing these values, we can calculate the insertion loss of that optical component. Now, it's worth noting that there are procedures for what's called a two-cable or three-cable reference or the cable substitution insertion loss test. We're not going to go over those today, except to mention that they do produce different results, and optical fiber components are commonly specified without saying which insertion loss test was used, so something to watch out for. The equipment that we'll be using today consists of, first, a light source. Typically, we'll use a laser for measuring single-mode fibers, and a LED for measuring multi-mode fibers. Today, we have a benchtop laser with a built-in isolator, so it is insensitive to back reflections. We're also using a power meter with a fiber-coupled power meter sensor. Importantly, the active area on the power meter must detect all of the light that's output from a fiber connector, so it's much larger than the fiber's core. And finally, we have a reference cable. This reference cable is attached to the light source, and it is going to consist of the same fiber type as the device under test. So today we have a reference cable that's made with the most current version of SMF28 fiber, and we're measuring at 1550 nanometers. And all the components we're measuring have FC-APC connectors, so the reference cable does on the output end as well. We have a small loop in the reference cable near the input end, and that's taped down. And the idea here is to filter out any cladding modes in the fiber so that they do not alter the results of our test. It's important to note that all of the fiber connectors must be clean for this test to have any precision. So we've gone through beforehand and cleaned and checked all of our connectors to make sure that they're clean. So the first part of the test is to attach the reference cable directly to the power meter. If we turn the light source on, we can see the optical power read from the end of the reference cable. I do have the power meter also set to 1550 nanometers, which is our test wavelength. The first thing I'll do is set the power meter to read dBs rather than milliwatts. Insertion loss in fiber components is commonly spec'd and measured in dBs, and this is useful when you have, for instance, an optical system with many fiber components, each with their own insertion loss value. Those values can be added together to find the total insertion loss of the system, rather than multiplied as you'd have to do with transmission percentages. And so fiber components are typically spec'd in dBs for the insertion loss. The next thing I'll do is I'll use the delta button on the power meter, and this is going to put the power meter into a relative power mode, where it's going to compare the reference power, which is measuring now, to a different power later on and show us the attenuation between those two measurements, the difference between those two measurements. So pressing the delta button, power meter now displays 0 dBs, and I can check the stability of my light source by turning it off and turning it back on, and we should see still measure 0 dBs. It does, so this light source is stable over time and acceptable for this test. Next, we'll plug the reference cable into a mating sleeve. Since we're using FC-APC connectors, we're using a narrow key mating sleeve. The first component we'll measure the insertion loss of is a simple 1 meter patch cable. So we'll plug one end of the patch cable into the mating sleeve to connect with the reference cable, and plug the other end into the power meter. Turning the light source on, we can see the insertion loss measured through this cable. Now, it's important to note at this point, what are we actually measuring? So the first thing that we're measuring is going to be the loss caused by this connection within this mating sleeve. And that's going to be caused by, for instance, a very slight misalignment in the fiber cores inside the mating sleeve. The second thing we'll measure is any attenuation or loss through this fiber length. What we're not going to measure is any loss related to the second connector. All of the light output from the connector will be detected by the relatively large active area of the power meter sensor. There is going to be a Fresnel reflection at that connector, but that's going to be canceled out in this test because the reference cable also had a Fresnel reflection when we had it plugged into the power meter. Now, to look at the insertion loss of the other connector, we can simply reverse the cable under test. Turning the light source back on, we can see that we measure a similar but slightly different insertion loss value. Now it's important to note that this insertion loss is caused by the connector to connector pair. So if we were to use a different reference cable, we would expect the insertion loss value to change a little bit as well. Now for this example, we're measuring a very short length of silica fiber. So besides the loss at these connectors, we're going to have effectively negligible loss through this length of fiber. So in the next example, we'll show the insertion loss measurement on a fiber component where there is some loss within the component. So for this example, we're going to show the insertion loss measurement for a 1x2 fiber coupler or splitter. The way a coupler works is there's one input fiber and two output fibers, and the signal from the input is split roughly 50-50 between the two output legs within a certain tolerance. So the first thing we'll do is we'll remeasure the reference power by connecting the reference cable to the power meter. We can see that the power meter reads roughly 0 dBs. I'm going to take it out of relative power mode and back in just to be safe and re-zero it. Next, we'll connect the reference cable to the 1x leg of the 1x2 coupler. And I'll connect one of the coupler's output legs to the power meter. First, we'll measure the output leg with the white frication tubing. Turning the light source back on, we can see the insertion loss through this leg of the fiber coupler. We measure a value that's slightly over 3 dBs, and this is what we'd expect. 3 dBs of loss is approximately 50% of loss, plus a little bit more. And what we're measuring here is actually the loss from the splitting action of the coupler, plus the loss at this connector-to-connector pair, similar to the patch cable example. And the third thing is going to be any internal attenuation in the coupler, which is commonly called the excess loss of the component. So we can plug in the other leg of the coupler to measure the insertion loss through that leg. Turning the light source back on. So here we see a slightly different value, but still right around 3 dBs and well within the splitting tolerance of the coupler. So that's been an overview of insertion loss testing for optical fiber components. We hope this was helpful for your application, and if you have any further questions, please contact tech support.